The federal government's diversification drive is paying off, especially in the agro-allied sectors of the nation's economy as investors embrace the business. We have a report. Still on the agro-allied sectors of the nation's economy, Agro Nigerian Ventures Limited's offering is revealed in our corporate report segment of the program. Plus, Estate Surveyors and Valuers Registration Board of Nigeria is in focus as the chairman, Estate Surveyor William Odudu, and the registrar, barrister, Estate Surveyor Ifeanyi, speak on the institution's value and the practice. And operators in the catering and confectionery business are catching in on the growing demand for their services. Plus other global business and financial news. This is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Hello, a very good day to you and thanks for joining us. My name is Kenneth Odushola Stevenson and this is Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. When we come back right after this commercial break, like you may have heard on the highlight, several investors are currently embracing the agriculture sector as the federal government drive to grow the sector is currently generating a lot of interest. We speak with so many other professionals and including farmers themselves and business investors on this practice and also the opportunities in the sector. Stay with Inside Business. We'll be right back. Welcome back. You're still Inside Business Africa, Africa's business news and information leader. Thanks for staying with us. Later on the program, you're going to be hearing about this important organization. Estate Surveyors Registration Board is driving sound practice in the industry. But for now, we're going to be focusing on the agri sector. The sector has continued to generate a lot of interest, especially from investors who are currently seeing that as the gold mine for Nigeria's economic prosperity. Inside Business Africa has gone around the country to speak with some practitioners in this sector and some investors on the opportunities. Here's the report.
More or less 70% of Nigeria's population engages in agricultural production at subsistence level. However, much of the Nigerian economy since the discovery of oil is driven by oil. With the advent of oil, agriculture was relegated to the background, and despite this unfortunate situation, the sector remained and accounts for about 42% of the gross domestic product GDP. Following the world food crisis and particularly the worsening food security situation in Africa, heads of states and government of Africa at the summit in Maputo in 2004 decided to provide a stronger political support to the Comprehensive Africa Agricultural Development Program, CAADP. Also, greater proportion of the population depend on the agricultural sector for their livelihood and the rural economy is still basically agricultural. The role of the agricultural sector in the overall response of the Nigerian economy to reforms and adjustment policies is very important because given its relatively large size, a large positive response to adjustment policies was expected as a means of improving the overall performance of the economy.
The agri sector is the only hope for Nigeria in terms of employment for our young people and feeding ourselves without relying on importation.
Agri in any part of the world plays one of the most goals in the economy.
I will tell him the importance of agriculture and how we can bring agriculture to a line life. Yes, because agriculture is all about finance, passion and zeal. Yes.
First of all, I would like to thank him for this opportunity, and I believe what we want from His Excellency and also what we want from the government overall, we want them to support, to keep supporting this sector. You know, it's very important. Nigeria is a huge country.
We were in the field, we've been in the field, we know what farmers are really going through. So what we do is, most of our products are tailor-made. We go to your farm, we see what you really need, then we give you what is suitable for that.
the changed mantra of the federal government in the agricultural sector in the current dispensation seems to have taken cognizance of the relevant and the position of the agriculture sector. Hence, the 2016 budget is tailored towards the sector and as well as the solid mineral to drive the process.
The point is, at times you look at it that government is not doing enough. You look at it another way, government is doing what it ought to have done. But the problem is the farmer themselves. And let me call that one. Then the second one, the farmer should be the second.
Yeah.
The first one is the policy maker. Who are those people that want to implement the policy? You know, you discover that they give a loan to farmer. You just hear it over the radio, over the newspaper and everything. You just start asking questions. Where is the loan? Where is the loan? You go to banks, banks will start telling you stories.
We have a very huge variety of products that can be more than 100 items. All are agro-related products and all are imported from all around the world. We have pesticides that come in three different families, herbicides, insecticides, and fungicides. We have fertilizers as well. We have seeds. All these products that can contribute to progress in this agricultural sector in the country.
The development will further encourage the stakeholders in the sector to double their effort and their participation and channel more resources and expertise to grow the agricultural sector in Nigeria.
But the most challenge we have is the infrastructure to have a good agri-business. Let's say about ourselves, as we are in poultry. As of today, our main problem is we don't have grain facilities, let's say in the state. We don't have any grain facility that can help farmers whenever you are having glut. For instance, now we are buying maize at 115 naira, which is very expensive.
The challenges are financial, because presently now I cannot even meet up the demands. I cover over 200 to 300 acres of land. You can see it on view. Yes, and a lot of companies are even coming telling me that, how can we get plantain from you? I said, I cannot even meet up the demand for now.
Then the challenges that are facing the farmers. Number one, as my brother said, finance. There is no finance, the financing method is so poor.
For us, actually, the main challenge that we have been facing, let me say, since last year is that economical situation that I believe everybody is facing it. Since we are importer, we have been facing a lot of challenges to pay our bills to the importer abroad, Nigeria.
But the problem, the main issue, barrier, as I can call it, of entry into the profession is capital. It's finance. It is capital intensive. So that is the issue. That is where governments ought to have come in.
Indeed, our special report on the agro-allied sectors of the nation's economy will continue on Inside Business for some time to come, but we have made it a point of duty to continue to reflect on the performance and the operations in this industry, especially focusing on organizations that are driving the process for economic prosperity of nations. Now, talking about economic prosperity and drivers of sectors, Agro Nigerian Ventures Limited is an Ekiti state-based organization that is currently doing quite a lot in the agro-allied sectors of the nation's economy, especially offering some of the unique practices, including tractor training and many more. Has a special focus on the organization's offering.
Agro Nigeria Ventures Limited, incorporated on July 30, 1987, as a private limited liability company, has diversified into agricultural equipment importation, agricultural marketing and equipment hiring, agricultural contract services of land clearing and preparation, and now to the training of agricultural service providers.
Currently, we are selling power tillers, but we are more concerned in training young people on the use of power tillers so that they can be empowered and encouraged to go into agriculture.
With a strong vision to be Nigeria's leading agricultural support service company, offering affordable mechanized agricultural equipment at the small and medium scale levels, thereby increasing agricultural production in the country, the firm strives to provide various agricultural needs of the farmers at reasonable and affordable prices in a clean, modern and accessible environment through its ANVL Farmers Depot, among others.
We are just starting. We are discussing with quite a number of institutions to partner with us in the training process. We have instructors who are versatile in the use of the power tiller that we have employed. We are talking to the African Leadership Forum at Ibadan, who we have signed an MOU with, to be part of the training in order to teach them on how to run their business, because the entire process is on self-employment. So ALF, African Leadership Forum, we handle the youth empowerment portion of it, while we do the technical field training, and we are also talking to a number of institutions to serve as the venue for the training. Well, we are mainly concerned with equipment that our rural farmers can use to improve their productivity in the agri sector. Basically, we import tractors, four-wheel tractors, but lately the price of four-wheel tractors have so much gone up that it's virtually becoming impossible for both government and private individuals to be able to own a four-wheel tractor. And so, looking at that, we have branched into importation of power tillers, which you may call a small farmer's tractor.
Experience and studies have shown that adequate mechanization will help drive Nigeria to a self-sufficiency in food production. Despite this, most farmers continue thus using hoe and cutlass for many farming operations. Now that Nigeria has been forced to change its focus back to agriculture for the economic growth, ANVL, through the ANVL Farmers Depot, continues to stand committed to offering appropriate and affordable mechanized farming equipment, particularly for the small farm holders. Power tillers, tractors, rice harvester, sprayer, lawn and garden equipment, etc. are affordable equipment that are available at the firm.
We are starting the Agric Academy basically to train and employ young people on how to use power tiller and the Agric implements. The training is for 8 weeks. After the training, we are looking forward to being able to approach any of the banks to do the empowerment for them.
Agro Nigeria Ventures Limited's mission is to become a leading player in the transformation of Nigeria's agriculture by meeting some of the needs of the farmers through the ASP program, while joining hands with the federal government that now must encourage its population to focus on agriculture as the source of our nation's economic prosperity and growth.
Well, first of all, we must find a way of attracting new blood to the agri sector. You cannot do agriculture successfully and profitably using cutlass and hoe. Therefore, anything we can do to train young people on the use of power tillers and then empowerment from the government whereby they can own a tractor, which is what I call power tiller. which we do the same thing that the big tractors do, except that it's far more economical. If we can find a way of training them and empowering them, I think a lot of, you will solve two problems. One, you solve the agric production problem. One. Two, you will encourage a lot of young people who are roaming the street looking for work that doesn't exist. You will attract a lot of thousands and millions of young people into agriculture. And then we can then start exporting some of these agri products if we can, after meeting our local needs.
Congratulations to Agro Nigerian Ventures Limited. We are proud to be associated with your progress and will continue to reflect on your performance and contribution to the nation's growth, especially from the agro-allied sectors of the nation's economy. When we come back, right after this important commercial break, we'll be talking with the chief executive and also the chairman of Estate Surveyors and Valuers Registration Board of Nigeria, ESVABON for short. We'll talk about their offerings and how they are ensuring a sound practice in the industry. Stay with Inside Business. We'll be right back. In 1954, the first Nigerian estate surveyor and valuer, John Wood Ekoyong, graduated from the University of London with a BSc degree in estate management. Since then, the profession has witnessed phenomenal growth and tremendous development. In 1969, the profession gained limelight in the country when a group of qualified chartered and general practice surveyors formed what is known as the Nigerian Institution of Estate Surveyors and Valuers, as a non-profit voluntary professional organization to cater for the interest of the landed profession in Nigeria. 6 years later, it was accorded government recognition by the promulgation of the Estate Surveyors and Valuers Registration Decree No. 24 of 1975, now Cap. 3, a law of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, 1990. The body has grown in leaps and bounds with over 3,723 registered members, according to the 36th induction ceremony performed by the chairman of the board, Elder William Odudu, a fellow of the Nigerian Institution of Estate Surveyors and Valuers.
We've achieved virtually all. In terms of fighting quacks, you've put in place a measure to bring estate agents under the fold of the board and get them properly registered so that we can regulate the practice. By doing that, you are reducing the number of quacks practicing in the profession. And to take it a step further, we have introduced what we call the adhesive stamp system. Any valuation that is done by registered estate surveyor and valuer must carry an adhesive stamp with an identity, with a number, so you can track down who carried out that evaluation and the date.
With strong vision to ensure qualified practitioners are entitled to practice and provide sound services with integrity, ESVABON Code of Ethics for Practitioners is administered by a board with several committees that work assiduously in setting the required standards for practice.
We believe that they will build on the foundation we've established, and they will improve on what we've done. I believe that the next board will do better than what we've done so far. And we believe that other boards will improve on what the upcoming boards will do.
We keep close vigilance over the profession, especially in its best practice. And that is why we ensure that before the license of any registered estate surveyor and valuer is renewed, he would have attained a certain number of continuing professional development.
Because of the peculiar nature of the practice and the need to ensure competitive advantage, the organization, according to the chairman, Elder William Odudu, and the registrar, Barrister Uzowani, conduct periodic workshops for practitioners to ensure they keep up to date with the global practices as well as evolving government policies relating to the industry and the practitioners.
This is to reduce quackery. So if you are a quack, you cannot get access to that adhesive stamp. Like the lawyers, is personal, is going to eventually be personalized. For example, a lawyer has an adhesive stamp which carries his name and date of or being called to the bar. You know, we want to also make sure that any valuation that is done by any registered estate surveyor and valuer will carry a stamp with a number.
Our societies must demand to be better served. Whether government, private or individual, or public, we must know that we must make a demand for better services and go for the right professionals.
Indeed, we are proud to be associated with the progress that has been made so far since the establishment of that particular organization, Estate Surveyors and Valuers Registration Board of Nigeria. And Elder William Ududu, as you will be handing over in October, we will also be sharing with you some of your experiences and legacy you'll be leaving behind before you do that, especially during the handing over ceremony. But moving on now on today's edition of the program, the confectionery business is growing. And many practitioners, especially investors, are embracing this business. And we decided to take a very important look at the operators and their offerings in this special report. The growth in the confectionery market in Nigeria has been seen based on an in-depth market analysis with input from industry experts. Reporting on the market landscape and its growth prospect over the coming years, operators believe the market is promising.
Actually, Laredo started way back. There was no particular time, probably around the late 80s. That is when we started as a party attendant.
Finger King, Meridian Prince, Adidas,
one trend which is expected to drive market growth expectedly is the demand for what is today called small chops and sugar-free confectionery products. With the changing consumer preferences, food processing companies now have varieties and low-calorie and sugar-free alternatives as part of their product lines.
To do my own thing has always been there. So when I came across two major companies doing small chops, the demand, the pressure was on them. They could not meet up the demand for their market. So I saw the gap. So I thought to myself that I could bridge the gap. I can fill the vacant. Then, so that was how we came into doing product business about 13 years ago.
Consumers are increasingly substituting small chops with low calorie sweetness. This has created a surge in the demand for the products. How then are the major players taking in this growth, and what are really the offerings?
The sector is just coming up. We have a very large market. Nigeria today, just very few people knows about what is called small chops. So it's still growing. It's an industry that's still growing, and there are a lot of opportunity for people to make their living.
You can also, you know, walk in and buy. So that's the kind of services we render. So it's not just party affair. You know, we started with party, but later we decided to, you know, to change the game so that we can serve those that need. Because we later realized there are other people who are inside, who are not, you know, a party goers, and they also want to have a taste of, you know, good food. So how do we reach on to those ones if we don't create avenue to serve those ones? So we're not just particular about party.
In addition, the increase in the expatriate population in line with increasing foreign direct investment and the use of expatriate for booming confectionery businesses, among others, and the growth of modern retail channels such as supermarkets and hypermarkets are key factors driving the quite strong growth of small shops and confectionery business in Nigeria.
I'm looking forward to when my people, my payroll, I'll be having like 1,000, 3 in 4 digits on my payroll. So that is when my target. And I'm looking forward to building the name to become a household name. When you want to talk of small jobs, you remember Finger King first.
The principal partner of Ashen Douglas & Co. We are a registered firm of estates of yours and Valois, and we've been in operation for since 2000. The company has been in operation, but I've been in practice for about 23 years. When you talk about housing and national development, they go in pari passu, they go in the same direction. Housing and national development. Because from the beginning of age, when you talk of food, the next thing you talk about is shelter.
Presently, what we are doing is we have a partner, a business partner based in Belgium. The solution is called Odoo. They're very visible. They are number one in that sector of open source ERP solution. ERP is enterprise resource planning. And what we are doing is basically as a business partner to drive that solution in the local environment, which is Nigeria, basically.
Well, that's about all we have time for on Inside Business Africa for today. I want to thank you very much indeed for being a part of the program, and also wishing you Barika de Sala. Whatever you do, just do it very wisely. It's important. We'll come back from the holiday hail and healthy. It's been Kenneth Odishola Stevenson presenting Inside Business Africa. Thank you again for watching. See you next week.